From the National Newsroom of the Canadian Press, I'm John Kennedy. Donald Trump will return to the campaign trail today with a news conference. The former U.S. president will speak at his namesake tower in Manhattan a day after he was convicted for trying to illegally influence the 2016 election through hush money payments to a porn actress who claimed they had an affair. Outside Trump's Mar-a-Lago estate in Florida, Luke Waterman, who never voted for Trump, says that he was convicted on the facts, and the hush money trial is only the beginning for the former president.
There's so many other horrible things he's done and lied about and put the country through, and it's divisive. And I just think it's important to come out here to let them know and to let him know that, he lost the popular vote twice. And so more people dislike him than like him here in this country.
Sentencing is set for July 11th. Authorities from the United States say human smuggling out of British Columbia and across the American border is soaring, with organized criminals moving people by freight train, Uber, or on foot. There were almost 43,000 encounters last fiscal year, up from about 12,000 2 years earlier. U.S. Homeland Security Assistant Special Agent Matthew Murphy says there's been an unprecedented spike in human smuggling through BC. Murphy says Indian nationals are the number one group seen trying to cross the Washington border illicitly. A federal government poll last year found a majority of Canadians believed a drug decriminalization policy would lead to an increase in overdose deaths.
That was months before British Columbia scaled back its drug decriminalization pilot. The Privy Council Office survey was posted online in the fall. It suggests Canadians were split over whether decriminalization would make their community any less safe. Decriminalization has grown into a political lightning rod over recent weeks after BC asked Ottawa to reverse a provision that stopped police from arresting people from doing drugs in public. Stephanie Taylor, The Canadian Press, Ottawa.
The United States and Britain attacked 13 Houthi targets in several locations in Yemen, responding to a recent surge in attacks by the Iran-backed militia group. The Houthi rebels have been striking ships in the Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden over the Israel-Hamas war. The militia reported that the airstrikes killed at least 16 people and wounded 35 others. Lava flowing from a volcano southwest in Iceland continued to spurt, but overall activity had calmed significantly from when it erupted a day earlier. The eruption last week was the fifth and most powerful since the volcanic system near Grindavík reawakened in December after 800 years of slumber. Volcanologist Dave McGarvey says he calculated the amount of lava initially flowing from the crater, which would have buried the soccer pitch at Wembley Stadium in London under 15 meters of lava every minute. This is the Canadian Press. In sports, the Florida Panthers are one victory away from returning to the Stanley Cup Final. They hung on for a 3-2 road win over the New York Rangers and take a 3-2 lead in the Eastern Conference Final. Florida lost to Vegas in last year's final. The Eastern Final winner will play the winner of the West Final between Edmonton and Dallas. That series is tied at 2 games apiece. Only 2 teams remain in the NBA postseason. The Dallas Mavericks eliminated the Minnesota Timberwolves with a 124-103 victory in Game 5 of the Western Conference Final. Luka Doncic had 36 points and 10 rebounds for the Mavericks. They'll play the Boston Celtics in the NBA Finals. 4 Canadian players are in the third round at the French Open. Bianca Andreescu, Felix Auger-Aliassime, Denis Shapovalov, and Leila Fernandez were victorious. There was one upset of note as American Peyton Stearns beat 10th-seeded Russian Daria Kasatkina. From the Canadian Press, I'm John Kennedy.
Thanks for listening. Don't forget to follow and subscribe. For more of today's top stories, visit thecanadianpressnews.ca.